Berwick TV, Berwick Kids TV, great to see you. This is Checkers the Clown, and I've come here to do a disappearing sponge ball trick. So what you need for the disappearing sponge ball trick is a sp- sponge ball, a magic wand, and yourself. Now, and it works best when you've got your red nose on. I lost my red nose the other day. I just didn't feel myself. Make sure you have your red nose on. It's so much more fun with a red nose. So, yes, here is the sponge ball. I'm going to put it in my hand. And voila, it's gone. How amazing is that? Just disappeared into thin air. I wonder where it is. Wow, there, behind my ear. How is that? Well, I thought rather than just showing you that trick, I'd teach you how to do it today. So you have your sponge ball, you have your hand, you put it in your hand, and as you close your hand, you move the ball into the corner of your other hand, you close quickly, get your magic wand, and the sponge ball has disappeared. So I want you to try that this week. Get yourself a sponge ball, get yourself a magic wand. You can just use your finger or you can use a magic wand, but that's all good. And I have a quick thought for you. You know, Jesus did miracles. Jesus did amazing miracles while he was on earth. He still does miracles today. Magic tricks, they are illusions. This doesn't actually happen, as I just showed you. But Jesus can defy the laws of nature because he created the laws of nature, and he can do miracles. He multiplied food, and he can do impossible things like that today. So if you're finding yourself in an arena, an area where you're thinking something is impossible, kids, for you or your family, ask Jesus to do a miracle in your life, and he is able. He is able to do far more than you can ask, think, or imagine. So that's Checkers saying goodbye. Practice your trick, and I'll see you next week. Aha!
Hello, everyone. It's me, Jasmine, from Nitro Kids, and today I'll be showing you how you can do soft basketball. Okay, everyone, what you'll need to play soft basketball is 6 of your most favorite pair of socks. Okay, so right here I have got all my favorite pair of socks, and I've got my cupcake socks, my cactus socks, my banana socks, and 2 of my most favorite watermelon socks, and the hairy moustache man socks. Okay, so first step you want to do is you want to roll your socks up so they can be little basketballs and you can throw them. Roll them up, they're going to end up looking like little donuts. Okay, there we go. See, like that, little donuts. Okay, and do this to the other one. Just keep rolling, rolling, rolling. Okay, there we go, like that. And you'll do them to the rest of the socks too. So now you've got your 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 basketballs. Now you'll need a bucket. Sorry guys, there's a lawnmower in the background, so if it's a bit noisy, just forget. So what you'll need is your bucket, and what you want to do is you want to put it on a chair. It doesn't matter if it's inside or outside, doesn't make a difference. So let's go get our socks. Okay, you want to get all of your, no, it fell, no, there goes more. Okay, I got them. Okay, so you want to put them down, and you want to try and get the sock in the bucket. And the further away the bucket is, the harder it might be. It's up to you how far away you want it to be. So let's give it a go. Okay, she goes, she shoots, she misses. That's okay. Let's have another go. Okay. No, she misses again. Let's come in a bit closer and see if I can get it in there. Okay. No, I'm just no, no. I think you guys might be better at this than me. Yes, I got one in. Okay, let's have another go. Ooh, that was a close one. No, okay. I got four more. Let's see if I can get them in. Yes, okay. She goes again. And she misses completely. That's okay. Ooh, that was a close. Okay, last one. Come on. You know you want to go in? Ooh, that was a close one.
Hey kids, Pastor Andrew here. Great to see you again. We're continuing our theme of perseverance today. Don't give up. How good was Micah's teaching last week? And today we are continuing with the life of the Apostle Paul. Now, did you know that Paul wasn't a good guy? His name was Saul. He was a religious leader, a Jewish religious leader. And he was kind of like a terrorist of his day. He didn't like that Christians were turning the world upside down, Christians were going out preaching the gospel, seeing people get saved, people were meeting Jesus, there was healings, there was miracles, there was even deliverances going on, and the Holy Spirit was moving in a mighty way through the disciples. And he hated that because he thought that he knew who God was, and the God he knew wasn't the God that he was seeing move in these Christians. So he got to a point where he rallied a whole lot of people and they got stones, and they started stoning a Christian guy called Stephen. So Stephen, he'd started off as working with the poor and helping the poor, and then he was moving out as an evangelist, and he was doing mighty miracles in the name of Jesus. This aggravated the Apostle Paul, and he got people together, and they actually stoned Stephen. And Stephen, just before he died from getting stoned, looked up into the sky. He saw a vision of Jesus, and he said to Jesus, "Forgive them, for they know not what they're doing." And then he took his last breath. What amazing faith he had, and what an amazing witness he was in his day. Then the Apostle Paul, or Saul at that time, he left, and he was on a mission to kill all the Christians. As he was going along a road called Damascus, he had an encounter. And there was this bright light that came down and blinded Saul. And out of the light, he heard a voice say, "Why are you persecuting me?" And Paul goes, "Who are you, Lord? Who are you?" And the voice said, "It is I, Jesus, whom you're persecuting." And when the vision finished, he was blind, and he got taken for 3 days until he was taken by some people who gave him residence 3 days' walk from there. It was at that time that there was this other guy called Ananias, and he loved God, and he was following Jesus with all his heart, and he had a vision where God told him to go and lay his hands on Saul and to pray for him that he would be baptized and filled with the Holy Spirit. And Ananias thought, "Wow, I don't want to do that. This guy is crazy. Woohoo, crazy. What are you telling me to do?" But he obeyed anyway. God told him exactly where to go with a word of knowledge, supernatural knowledge. And he walked there and he walked in. He saw Saul there. He laid his hands upon him, prayed for him. It was like scales fell from Paul's eyes. And he was filled with the Holy Spirit and power. And he did not look back. So before he was a Christian, his name was Saul. But then God changed his name to Paul, and we know him as the Apostle Paul. Now the Apostle Paul went on to plant many churches, to raise up many leaders, to do signs, wonders, and miracles. He even raised someone from the dead. And he wrote many books in the New Testament of the Bible. So his influence is unprecedented. His influence has had a ripple effect, a momentum that continues today. And it's going to continue until Jesus comes back, because he has written the Bible to instruct and to teach and to equip every Christian until Jesus returns. It's quite possible that we wouldn't be Christians if it wasn't for him, because of the amount of Christians or people that he led to Christ who have then led others to Christ today. And Ananias, what a man, obeys God. If it wasn't for Ananias, Paul wouldn't have done all that he did. What an amazing story. So, yeah, Paul was filled with the Holy Spirit, but that didn't mean his life was easy. He speaks about being stoned. He speaks about being shipwrecked. And eventually he was killed for his faith in Christ. He had a hard, he had many trials and a hard life, but it was all worth it because he knew who he was following. He knew his purpose, and he followed Jesus no matter what. He persevered through difficulty. And because he did so, God developed him, God strengthened him, and God continued to use him in mighty, mighty ways. So Paul followed God with all of his heart, no matter what he went through. He always, in the trials, in the difficulties, he put God first, he sought God, he prayed, and he learned from God. He followed God all the way. And today we have YouTube followers, we have Facebook followers, we have Instagram followers, and they're like flippant followers. We just follow anyone. But that's not what God wants. It's not what Jesus means by being a Christ follower. He wants us to trust him through thick and thin, through the good times and the bad. And when we do that, we will reap a reward that will influence many people for decades and even centuries to come, like the Apostle Paul. So I don't know what you're going through today, kids. I know that COVID-19, it's a difficult time. Maybe you haven't gone to school. Maybe you're missing your friends. Maybe it's a bit of cabin fever at home and there's arguments going on. Maybe you're bored. Maybe you miss what you had before. And I just want to encourage you today, put Jesus first, trust in him, pray to him, ask him for strength, ask him for wisdom, ask him for knowledge, and he will give you all those things because he is good and kind and he wants the best for you. So why don't I pray for you that you can persevere, not give up, and follow Jesus for the rest of your life. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, I just thank you for the Apostle Paul. I thank you for his life. I thank you that we can emulate him. And I pray that we would follow you with all our hearts through the thick and thin, through the good times and the bad, and learn from you, be strengthened by you, and influence the world around us through following you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Well, bless you heaps. I hope you got something out of that. And I'll see you next week.
Did I scare you? Probably not. You're too brave. Welcome to your favorite part of the morning. And with your favorite leader. Please don't tell the other leaders I said that. It is I, Jess, ready to teach you guys the new memory verse for this month. This is what the new memory verse says. It says, "Let us not become tired of doing good. At the right time, we will gather a crop if we don't give up." Galatians 6:9. Action time. Let us not become tired of doing good. At the right time, we will gather a crop if we do not give up. Galatians 6:9.
Think you got it? I think you can do it.